Yeah, the pandemic has been a big pain in the bum for those who are single and ready to mingle. Maybe I should have rephrased that, but anyway. Luckily, we can still live through the dating lives of others with reality TV.
Well, from dating naked to sexy beasts, we've witnessed the full spectrum of kooky dating shows. Have a look.
I mean, with any luck.
Love is a many splendid thing.
Love them or hate them, TV shows have been playing Cupid for nearly 40 years.
Well, Janelle, tough decision when you make a match a piece. What's going through your mind?
They all sound pretty good put together.
Yeah? You want to take all three?
Number one.
Number one!
Since the 80s, our appetite for dating shows has grown exponentially.
Part of our makeup to be able to wonder what it would be like to be in those romantic kind of relationships that novels and movies are based on. People place themselves in it. And they also place their relationship in it, and they start to compare and look at these shows for a little bit of guidance.
In the search for love, we've seen men pushed into pools, watched singles stripped down for their suitors.
What's your name?
Noel, what's your name?
Noel, I'm David.
David?
Yeah. Good to meet you.
Me too. I was just like, penis. So I was like, what's his name? I can't remember his name.
And seen the claws come out.
You asked me to be your girlfriend. You asked me to be your girlfriend so you can get through to the finals because you're a game player.
I'm a game player.
Some shows have sought to foster deeper connections by removing the physical.
Welcome to my pod.
Yeah. Nice to hear from you. Can't say see ya.
But not everyone is convinced.
When we're falling in love, we really want to see the person. Being able to lock eyes on someone is going to help with the attraction and help size up whether you think someone's good for you.
So can you really find true love on a dating show?
Look, I absolutely think that you can find love on a reality show, but I think it is in the minority. With reality TV, there are so many distractions and competitiveness, which for some is great, and for others, it really, really creates too much anxiety. So they aren't able to show their true selves.
Despite the numerous weddings and babies, some are still sceptical that the genre isn't all scripted.
I don't think faking your feelings on a reality show is very easy at all. We've all got our spidey senses when we're seeing people together and whether they really are in love. And it can be little things like we don't see the corners of the mouth pointing up, because the brain in love, you'll always find the corners pointing up or being happy or smiling. I know that I would be able to detect it pretty quickly, but I also think normal people out there watching television, I think that they can pick it as well.
Decades on from the dating game, streaming giant Netflix is dipping its toes in the dating pool with shows like Too Hot to Handle. Love. And the new bizarre offering, Sexy Beasts.
I am so single, I'm dressed as a panda bear to try to find a connection with somebody.
Hey, I mean, it's working.
But will the gimmicks be enough to capture our attention?
But I think in time, we will start to get a little bit more bored with it. Relationship shows where you have a therapist that are helping people get together in a different type of way, not only using science, I think would make great television. That's where I think we're going to head. It's going to become a little bit more real, or maybe a little bit more documentary style, and it's something I'd love to see.
Often. How good's that? All right, still to come.
A lot of kissing in that.